Hello everyone, I am Davide Scaramuzza from the University of Zurich, the Robotics and Perception Group, and today I would like to talk to you about a very exciting research that we've been working on in my lab for the past couple of years, which is about learning vision-based agile drone flight from perception to action. This talk will be presented both by myself and by my PhD student Antonio Loquercio. Flight is one of the most exciting locomotion principles, but also one of the most challenging ones. Birds are a big source of inspiration for researchers because they can navigate agilely in very complex environments, such as slaloming between trees, passing through narrow gaps, perching, and catching objects. Human pilots are catching up as well in agility, and drone racing is becoming a sport. However, if you look at the performance of autonomous drones today, this is still far from human pilot performance in terms of speed, versatility, and robustness. Human pilots take years to acquire their skills. And this raises the question, can we build an alpha pilot that can fly drones as good or even better than human pilots? This is both my dream and the goal of my research lab. If we are successful, we would like to be able to demonstrate one day a drone that can beat the best human pilot at a drone racing competition. Our goal as a community is to push the limits. And to push the limits, we need to work on really hard stuff. At my lab, we want to push the limits on vision-based navigation. And in my opinion, agile flight is one of the most exciting and hardest challenges of the next decade. It is the next moonshot. Remember what US President JF Kennedy said in his famous speech on why we choose to go to the moon. He said, "We choose to go to the moon not because it's easy, but because it's hard, because the goal will serve to organize and measure the best of our energies and skills." Also, agile flight raises fundamental challenges for robotics research in terms of perception, planning, and control. Additionally, making drones faster increases their range, currently limited by their battery life, which is key for search and rescue, inspection, and drone delivery applications. In this talk, we want to share with you our results on drone racing, drone acrobatics, and uncertainty estimation in deep networks. In these video previews, you can see two of our most recent and exciting results, autonomous drone racing and acrobatics. As you will learn, the algorithms that we developed were only trained in simulation and deployed into the real world without any fine-tuning. Our drones are fully autonomous and rely on visual inertial sensors and onboard computation. No GPS and no motion tracking systems were used. Let's start with deep drone racing. This research was presented in these five research papers and was done in collaboration with the Intel Network of Intelligence Systems led by Vlad Lenkultun. Let's start with the results first. In this video, our drone navigates autonomously a race course using a combination of model predictive control, visual inertial odometry, Kalman filtering, and shallow neural networks. In the back, you can also appreciate my students racing for fun against the drone. Our system uses two onboard cameras, a front-facing camera for gate detection and a downward-facing camera for visual inertial odometry. Computation instead runs on board two embedded computers, an Intel up board that runs the shallow network and path planning, and the Qualcomm Snapdragon flight board that runs visual inertial odometry. At this point, you may wonder, why not directly mapping end-to-end input images to control commands? The reason is that current end-to-end approaches that map pixels to control actions are significantly outperformed by approaches that work by generating intermediate representations. As shown in this Science Robotics paper, currently, models equipped with intermediate representations train faster, achieve higher task performance, and generalize better to previously unseen environments. Let's get back to the topic of drone racing and its challenges for robotics research. To solve autonomous drone racing, we need to solve two steps. The first step is to plan a global trajectory that minimizes the execution time from the start to the finish. The second step is to execute this trajectory. Trajectory execution is currently the hardest step because of disturbances, inaccuracies in our models of the system and of the environment, and because of state estimation drift. This makes it necessary for the drone to constantly detect and keep track of the next visible gates and use these detections to replan a local trajectory that accommodates for deviations from the global path. A key challenge, though, is how to couple perception with trajectory planning. You may wonder, why is tight coupling of perception and action necessary? To understand it, look at this animation. If disturbances or drift occur, the drone will need to replan a local path to accommodate for deviations from the optimal global path. But to do so, we must guarantee that the replanned trajectory satisfies a perception objective, which is that the gate remains visible by the drone's onboard camera. To do so, we must bridge the gap between perception and action. To address this problem, we proposed a model predictive control framework that combines classical action objectives with perception objectives. Action objectives are satisfying the under-actuated system dynamics, guaranteeing reference tracking, and respecting the input limitations. Perception objectives are guaranteeing the visibility of a point of interest, for example the gate, and minimizing motion blur. We call our framework PAMPC, which stands for Perception-Aware Model Predictive Control. To solve this problem, we define some perception state, we assign it a cost, and add it to the cost function of the optimization problem, which now jointly considers perception and action together. The perception state Z consists of two elements. S is the distance between the image center and the projection of a point of interest on the image plane, plus its derivative S dot. These two terms force the MPC to favor trajectories that maximize the visibility of the point of interest and minimize its speed on the image plane, so as to minimize motion blur. Let's go back to our drone racing task. Our approach for drone racing is inspired by the way human pilots race drones, which is to fly as fast as possible towards the next gate. The task of detecting the gate pose relative to the drone, together with its uncertainty, is performed by a deep neural network. This information is then used to update the pre-computed global minimum time trajectory through the track, which is denoted in blue, with a new gate-conditioned optimal trajectory using optimal filtering. The resulting trajectory, in red, is then executed by our perception-aware MPC controller. Collecting ground truth data for the task of gate detection is a tedious and expensive task. Indeed, training a network which can reliably detect gates might require up to 50,000 images in diverse environments. To ease the data collection problem, we collect data in simulation. We ensure sim-to-real transfer by using domain randomization. Specifically, we randomize everything we want the perception to be invariant of, which is illumination, background, gate color, and shape. Thanks to this variability, no photorealistic simulator was necessary for this task. In this video, you see our policy trained in simulation generalizing to the real world. On the right, you see the predicted gate poses in green and the initial course gate poses in red. The predicted covariance is denoted by the purple ellipsoid. As you can see, as the drone approaches a gate, the covariance shrinks accordingly to our intuition. In the bottom left of the video, you see the drone's onboard view. The colored axis in this camera view represent the projection of the gate pose predictions into the camera coordinate frame. As you can see, the predictions are a bit shaky at the beginning, but get more stable as the drone approaches the gate. In this video, you can see our policy generalizing to another environment. Remember that the network was only trained in simulation. Here, we tested the capability of the network to cope with moving gates. Recently, we extended our work to also take into account multiple gate detections. The final system was deployed in the 2019 Alpha Palo Drone Racing Challenge, where we won the second place among 430 participants worldwide. In these sequences, you can appreciate the speed of our drone ranging from 5 to 8 meters per second. All the algorithms run on board a Jetson Xavier board. And more details are given in the RSS paper below. Enjoy the video. Okay, so at this point I would like to give the word to my PhD student, Antonio Loquercio, who will talk about deep drone acrobatics and uncertainty estimation in deep network.
Hello everybody, my name is Antonio Loquercio, and I'm gonna present you one of our latest and super exciting projects on agile flight, drone acrobatics. Acrobatic flight with quadrotors is extremely challenging. Maneuvers such as the loop, matty flip, or barrel roll require high thrust and extreme angular acceleration that push the platform to its physical limits. Human drone pilots require many years of practice to safely master such agile maneuvers. Yet, a tiny mistake could make the platform lose control and brutally crash. The question is, of course, why do we want to do acrobatics with autonomous drone? Well, the main reason is that it raises fundamental challenges in robotic perception and control, in which of course we are interested. Also, as you've seen, they are challenging also for human pilots, and they represent a perfect test bed for developing new algorithms. Eventually, their development would be extremely valuable in many other applications, like for example search and rescue or autonomous delivery. There has been previous work on agile flight. However, the majority of it was in a controlled environment where it was assumed to have near perfect state estimation coming from external sensor. Another set of works, which did not assume near-perfect state estimation, was only limited to low acceleration trajectory, or could only fly very short and very specific trajectories only. We show, for the first time, that a vision-based autonomous quadrotor that only has access to onboard sensing and computation is capable of flying acrobatic maneuvers with acceleration of up to 3G. In spite of the perception and control challenges raised by such acceleration, our drones can fly all maneuvers in a robust and reliable fashion. In order to achieve this, we train an end-to-end sensimotor controller which directly regresses drone control commands from visual and inertial measurements. Our controller is trained exclusively in simulation. Simulation is fast, cheap, and safe. It does not require any human annotation, and it enables the collection of a large, almost unlimited amount of data in a limited time. Our training takes from 4 to 6 hours on a normal desktop machine. We ensure seamless transfer from simulation to the real quadrotor by employing appropriate abstraction of the sensory inputs. Using such abstraction, the policy generalizes to different indoor and outdoor environments, as well as to different physical drones. We mathematically show that these abstractions strictly limit the simulation to reality gap with respect to using raw informations, such as, for example, images or raw inertial measurement. Specifically, we train our policies on feature tracks instead of raw frames and of integrated IMU signal instead of raw inertial measurements. With such abstractions, our policy generalizes to different simulation environment without any randomization. Our end-to-end policy takes input inertial and visual information and produce as output the drone control commands. Of course, one question could be how to process such information. Indeed, a visual measurement come at a limited frequency, like for example 10-15 Hz, while inertial measurement they come way faster, like for example 200 Hz. In order to process this asynchronous data, we design an asynchronous architecture that you can see here in the figure, which is informed of an history of measurement through temporal convolutions, and that updates its output only with respect to the latest available sensor, so with the frequency of the fastest of the sensors. We evaluate our approach on a different set of maneuvers. In particular, we concentrate on some well-known tricks in the drone acrobatics community for human pilots, which are the power loop, the barrel roll, and the Matty loop. We also consider a combination of them that we call the combo. These maneuvers require acceleration of up to 3G. We thoroughly evaluate our pipeline in simulation, where we show that our approach obtains results which are superior to a controller which is based on the classical estimation and control pipeline. In particular, with respect to traditional approaches for drone flight, our learn policy makes the drone fly more consistently and precisely, while reducing the odds of a crash by up to 25%. Interesting from this result, we see that inertial measurement play a more important role than visual measurement, in particular for short maneuvers. But of course, the longer the maneuver, the more important the visual component is for reducing the drift. In spite of the perception and control challenges, our drones can fly all maneuvers in a robust and reliable fashion. Equipped with our learn controller, our drones are in fact more agile than ever before. In fact, they can fly maneuvers which are extremely challenging, even for human experts. The use of end-to-end policy for control of drones raises of ever a question. Can we always trust the output of a neural network? It is clear that a robotic system cannot blindly trust the predictions of a neural net. In fact, what if some of the sensors fail? Or what if the current observation is very different from the training ones? What it will happen, of course, that the neural network predictions will be off and could cause the robot, for example, to lose control or, crash. In order to account for this problem, we propose a general framework for uncertainty estimation of deep neural network predictions. Our framework captures the two main sources of uncertainty in neural network predictions, which are data uncertainty, which comes from the sensor noise, and model uncertainty, which instead derives from the training procedure of the neural network. This work, published at the Robotics and Automation Letter, ended ICRA this year, has an open source code, so please go ahead and try it out. Our general framework for uncertainty estimation combines Bayesian neural networks with variational inference. With respect to the state of the art for uncertainty estimation, we make use of information which are already available to the drone, like, for example, the sensor noise, which, of course, we know by reading the sensor specifications. Also, we model the relationship between the two uncertainty, data and model, showing that this is fundamental for accurate uncertainty estimation. Our framework is very general and flexible. Indeed, it offers some interesting features which could be important for the robotic or vision researcher. For example, it is agnostic to the neural network architecture and task. It is also agnostic to the learning process or the optimizer used, and it can even be applied to neural networks which have already been trained. We test our general framework for uncertainty estimation on several computer vision and control tasks, like end-to-end steering angle prediction, as you can see in this video, object future motion prediction, object recognition, classification, and even closed-loop control of a quadrotor. In all of these tasks, our framework outperforms other works for uncertainty estimation, thanks to its ability to model the data and the relationship between the data and model uncertainty, and to use prior information. We are now in the conclusion, and what I hope you will remember from my talks are the following points. First, that prediction uncertainty is necessary for integrating neural networks into robots. We cannot just do without it. Also, that simulation offers great opportunity to train end-to-end policies for robot control or navigation. To solve the sim-to-real transfer, a good approach is to abstract the sensor measurement, like, for example, we have done in our work with feature track for images. This is indeed decreases the simulation-to-reality gap and makes the trained policy in simulation work perfectly on a real drone. Thank you very much for your attention.